In the history of the World War II, it is difficult to find a ship comparable to the British cruiser Edinburgh in terms of the number of legends surrounding its sinking. It all started with the unusual cargo it was carrying – gold intended to be delivered from the USSR to Great Britain. On April 28, 1942, the QP-11 convoy of 13 merchant ships left Murmansk. It was escorted by 12 warships, including the light cruiser Edinburgh. The ship was flying the flag of Rear Admiral Stuart Sumner Bonham Carter, commander of the 18th Cruiser Squadron. Prior to departure, the cruiser was loaded with 93 wooden crates containing 465 bars of gold, weighing a total of 5,536 kilograms. The contents of the crates were known only to the cruiser's senior officers. At the same time, a counter-convoy was at sea, PQ-15, heading for Murmansk. On April 30, 2 days after the departure of the convoy, the QP-11 was detected by the German boats. The commander of the submarine U-456 maneuvered for a long time, but finally took advantageous position and fired 3 torpedoes. 2 of them hit the cruiser and caused the most damage. The first left a large hole in the starboard side, just below the bridge. The second hit the stern. Although the torpedo explosions did no damage to the cruiser's machinery, she lost control. The second torpedo destroyed 2 starboard propellers and tore the rudder. At 6 a.m. on May 2, German and British ships clashed, causing casualties on both sides. One of the torpedoes fired by the Germans hit Edinburgh again, but she was still afloat. An attempt to salvage the cruiser and tow it to Murmansk was a failure. Minesweepers removed the crew, and destroyer Forsyth fired a torpedo at Edinburgh, sinking the cruiser. The start of the gold recovery operation was May 9, 1981. The salvage vessel Demeter found the cruiser at a depth of 250 meters 5 days later. It was on the bottom, on the left side. After the determination of the exact location of the Edinburgh, preparations for the gold recovery operation were underway. The operation was difficult at the very beginning. It turned out that the size of the hole did not allow a diver to pass through it. Also, the sharp edges were too dangerous for the diver. In order to enter the ship, they had to cut a special hole in the hull. Then it took 10 days to clear the debris in the corridors of the cruiser to get to the room where the gold was. But one day, a 27-year-old diver from Zimbabwe, John Rossier, shouted into a microphone, "I found it! I found the gold!" The first precious bar was brought to the surface. One by one, gold nuggets were pulled from layers of silt and fuel oil. Over the next 19 days, 431 gold bars weighing 5,129 kilos were raised from the Edinburgh. The value of the gold raised from the seabed amounted to $81 million. In the fall of 1986, 29 of the 34 ingots remaining on the seabed were recovered, with a total weight of 345 kilos. It wasn't possible to find another 5 bars weighing 60 kilos. They're still at the bottom of the Barents Sea. On the day of the end of the deep-sea operation, a wreath was lowered into the water. A ceremony was held to commemorate the lost sailors of the cruiser Edinburgh. Today, one of the gold bars that was raised is a part of the permanent exhibition in the Diamond Fund of the Russian Federation. Thank you all for watching. You can support our channel by becoming a sponsor for only $1, or you can send us a super thank. Good luck to all!